Sisters and brothers, on this the fifth Sunday of Easter, we begin with the hymn, God is Love, Let Heaven Adore Thee, by Timothy Rees, sung by the Isle of Man Methodist Church. The readings appointed for the day are Acts chapter 8, verse 26 through 40, Psalm 22, verse 24 through 30, 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 through 21, and St. John chapter 15, verse 1 through 8. I will read the gospel appointed for today, after which we'll follow the song I Am the Vine by John Michael Talbot. I will then pray the collect for the day. This will be followed by the message from Father Garfield, and after the message we close up an arrangement of the song Abide in Me by Andrew Marcus. A reading from the Word of God, written in St. John chapter 15, beginning at verse 1. Jesus said to his disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that does not bear fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The word of the Lord.
I am the vine, and my Father is the keeper. Come to me, let the Spirit bring you life. Like a tree planted by the living water, to stretch its roots into the living stream. You will show no distress in the heat of the drought, but still bear fruit and live. And my Father is the keeper. Come to me, let the Spirit bring you life. Father is the keeper. Come to me. Let the Spirit bring you life. Come to me. Let the Spirit bring you
love. Let us pray. Almighty God, whom truly to know is everlasting life, grant us so perfectly to know your Son, Jesus Christ, to be the way, the truth, and the life, that we may steadfastly follow his steps in the way that leads to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I fervently believe that whatever we do in this life must be grounded in something, something that keeps us firm and anchored, something that drives us, that gives us life and energy and a zest and zeal for whatever we engage in. For me, I believe that whatever we are grounded in must be outside of ourselves, must be bigger than us, must be more unexplainable than the machinations of human minds and hearts and the everyday doings of human beings. And so for me, I take that grounding and that source, that life-giving energy, that fire, to be God, and God as expressed in and through Jesus the Christ. And I believe that God bids all of us to remain grounded in him as the source of our lives and as the driving force behind all that we do and all that we are. And that is why Jesus says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser, who takes care, who guides, who prunes, who ensures that the vine remains healthy and viable and fruitful. And Jesus invites us to remain connected to him as the source of life. Just as a child in the womb is directly connected to the mother and draws sustenance from the mother and is sustained by the mother, so it is that Jesus bids us to remain connected to him as our source of life and light and energy and all that we do. So Jesus says, abide in me. So it means to remain, to stay, to be connected to. And throughout our lives, if we do not abide in God through Jesus Christ, who is the source of life, through that divine energy and fire that sustains the whole world and gives it its beauty and its radiance and all the wonders that we experience, then we become really like the living dead. We are dry. We become depressed, distressed. We become listless and we become lifeless. So I bid each of us that in order to find our source of life, look to Jesus, remain in him and abide in him. Because apart from him, he says, we can do nothing. So everything that we try will seem to turn to frustration. And the frustrations of life will overcome us. But when we abide and we remain in God through Jesus Christ, then no matter what frustration or difficulties that we face, hard though they may be, they shall not overtake us. We shall continue to strive. We shall continue to live. Sometimes even when we do not know how, we find that energy and the will to go on. But it is not us. It is the connection and the abiding that we do in and through Jesus Christ. So listen to the words of Jesus. Abide in him. Remain connected to him. Stay in him. And when we stay in Jesus, then our love becomes stronger, our hope becomes brighter, and our pain, difficult as they might be, are washed away and swept up in the love and the goodness of God in Jesus Christ, in whom we abide and in whom we live and move and have our very being. God bless you. Amen.
I am the vine, you are the branch, do not forsake me. Come and reside with me and I'll show you my glory. Abide in me. I am the bread of life, with me you won't go hungry. I am the way, I am the truth, receive my mercy. Abide in me. Stay in me.